or shu is based on long fist or changquan with extended arm movements, high kicking, low stances, explosive jumping techniques, and high degree of difficulties. The Beijing team performs its group long fist routine with utmost precision and martial spirit. Erect with no movements from the upper body while kicking. Outside crescent kick. The inside crescent kick. These different leg techniques are meant to develop different parts of the leg, waist, hips. The back sweep. Typical wushu movement consists of low stances, full extension of the limbs, fast and precise kicking, high leaping, with focused power and dynamic spirit, accentuating every movement. Now the stance and the hands. This movement is called spear palm drop stance. Hands must be quick, focused, stance must be high and low. Next, the jumping exercises. First, we'll start with the warm-up jumps. Chinese stress basic training extensively, even though these athletes are the best in the world in wushu. The basics you see before your eyes are drilled twice a day. Jumping front kick. The jump, the kick, and the landing all done on the same leg. Jumping double front kick. Jumping inside crescent kick, or better known as a tornado kick in Chinese. Thank you. twist. Although each of the four styles of conditioning has characteristic features of its own, they share the following essentials. First, the body is naturally extended and relaxed, giving priority to leisureliness, which is soft, light, and agile movements. Second, the mind is tranquil but alert, with consciousness commanding the body. Tai Chi Chuan requires that the hands, eyes, body, and limb perform as a whole. Three major systems of internal wushu is Tai Chi, Xing Yi, and Ba Gua. This is one of them. Ba Gua Zhang, performed by Zhang Yu. Thank you.